In this video, we are going to see how to access a private function. In the previous videos, what we have seen is how to access a private member variable from the main. Once you have declared the private members inside a class, how you can access it from the main. So once you have declared them as a variable, a private variable, you can access them using the private member functions. Okay, you cannot direct access it. Say for example, this is what we have seen in the last class. Say for example, I have declared a variable to be private, say data. Now let me declare this as a private and I try to access it here, the main program. Say for example, I can directly assign variable value for this. Equal to, I can assign like this. First, let me run this program. So this is possible. See, through here, what we have given is, we have returned some function called set author name, where we pass this value. Okay, actually this is different. Let me give this some name X. Okay, now from here the main program. Here in the main program we have declared an instance. We have created an instance of the class author by using the new operator. Then we have used set author name. This is a member function through which we pass the variable for this public for this member variable. So here we pass and this is assigned to that. Now we can, since it is a public variable, if I don't declare them explicitly, don't give the access specifier, then it becomes a public. By default, it is public. So I can assign like this also. Now we'll see how it get executed. Just I'll undefined variable name. So here it shows that we can't directly access that, but so I think the previous one I have made a mistake by, it's like this I have to give. I think now it works. Okay. We'll see how this exists. See, there is no error because I have not echo the value, but here see, I have assigned some value that that is also accepted here. Okay, so let me print and let me give an echo statement here so that you can see. See here we have called the set author name and then we try to execute that. Then again here we are assigning another name. First we are passing Sujata and then this is assigned. Now I am assigning another value. Since it is a public variable, I am able to directly access it from the main program. So here I am assigning the value test. Now if I give the, let me see, let me display the value which is stored in that. So you can give like this, echo value. value in name is just so when I display that dollar data name, here I give this. So in this case it will display the value Sujata, because this is what currently assigned, and then we give this, it will be displaying that. We'll see how it works. See here, now the same statement I'm giving again after the assignment of this test. I will see how it gets executed. See here, value in name is test. So what is the meaning of this? Here we have declared some class called author, and this is a public variable. Okay, so this public variable, here we are using a function that is also a public function. So here we have given the name set author name, and we pass the value which in turn is assigned to the public variable. Here what we have declared is, we have created a object, instance of an object which is of type the author class. Then we have used the public method set author name, in which we pass the argument. So this will be assigned to this local variable, that is a member variable, and then here we are able to access it. Because it is a public variable, we are able to access it directly here like this. So Sujata, then we have used the instance name, and then member variable. Then we assign, since here itself we are able to access it directly because it is a public variable. Then here again we are assigning some value, like how we pass the argument and we assign that. Here we directly assign a value for this, and then he display. All these things work out. Now let us see how, whether we can access assign a variable for the private variable. This is a private variable. Now I try to access, see how it gives me error. I cannot access a private variable outside the class. So let me assign some value. Now we'll see what error it gives. I can see here I have used this as if it is declared here. Okay, I'm able to access it. We'll see the same way I'm using X also. Here already I have declared it as a private. We'll see how it works. Let's save. Now we'll see. See the error, because you cannot access private property directly. So that is why it is posting me the error. Now I want to access this private variable. How to access? That is through the existing function, public function only you can access. So if you see that, see here, I can access it only through the functions which I have declared here. So here it is private access. Now let me write, let me pass some value. Another. Let me pass this. And then I have to assign it like this only. Dollar this. And then X equal to dollar Y. Then once I assign this, I can get it by the public function, another function called public. Now return. Through this only, through any, I can access it only through another function. I cannot access directly here. Now it will not show me the error. I'll show you that. Now we'll see. So let me remove all these things. Okay. Now how we can access, instead of accessing it directly, we can access it through the functions, that is which we have declared, member functions. Through member functions we can access the value. So what this is doing here, we have assigned a variable, then we pass some value for that. Okay, let me say some value 5, some numerical value I'm assigning, and set author name Sujata, and then 5. Now this Sujata will be attached with this dollar data, that will be passed as a value for this, and this 5 is passed as this value. And this is a public variable, and this is what we are sending this value is for a private variable which is declared inside. Now this is assigned to this public and this is assigned to this private. How I can access it? I can access it by writing another function which is a public function here. So get author name, since I have not given any access specific here, by default it is a public. So return this name and it is. So like this only I can access. Now we'll see whether I can print it. The name of author is comma. I have to call the get author name. So dollar. I can't return two values. So what I am doing is here get author name, and then function. Let me have this as an age, something like that. So 35. Let me say. Get age. Let me declare it is has to be age. That is more appropriate instead of x. So here. Okay. So get age. Now open return dollar this, because this is used to for current object and current number variables. Okay. On functions age. Now close the class. Now I can access the name of the author is as Sujata by calling the function get author name. Okay, so here when I execute this function, here this is used to set the values. For setting you can use the same function, but for returning, since the function will return only one value, I'm using two different functions. One is for returning the author name and another one is for returning the age. Now we'll see how this gets executes. The author age author is, let me give some beer so that break line break. Okay, so get age. Now we'll see how it gets executes. See, the number, the name of the author is this and the age of the author is 35. So what we have done is, this is a public function and these are also a public function. Okay, first we set the values using a function and then we return the value through this. So this is even if age is a private, we are able to manipulate that only through a public functions. Let us imagine this is what about the private members. How to access a private function? So now we'll see how to access a private function. Now imagine this to be a private. So how you can make a function to be private? By prefixing the keyword private before a variable or a function. Okay, so now this has become a private. How can I access it here outside? Now let us see whether I can access it directly. So what we are doing here is, so using the get author name, we will be able to directly access this if it is declared it as a public function. Now let us imagine we have added the keyword private before the function, so that now it becomes a private function. So how to access this? Let us give me like this. Let us see what mistake, what error this will post. Here I am trying to access, see that dollar Sujata, just like that how I am accessing, you are trying to access it directly here. Okay, okay, already I have given here return this name. Okay, we'll see what error it is posting. So here we have used, we have given this two variables, we have passed And author name, get author name, we have declared it as a private and we try to access it. Let's see. See, call to private method. You can't call directly the ones which is declared as a private. So now how to access a private function? Yes, again you have to write a public function in the class, and then through that public function only you can access a private function. So now we'll see this. Here public, we have written another function call. Already we have written this, where we assign the values for a public and private variables. Then see here, display author name, we have used one more public function called display. That is, this is a public function. And then we call from this function, we call this get author name. And then we return the value which is written by that. So inside that we return this name. And then this value is returned through this public function. So here we call along with this, using this variable, we can call this member function which is declared as a private. And then the value which is returned by this will be returned to the main program. So you can access it through a, now we'll see whether it is posting any error. Here this definitely will post error because this is a private. So now I close all those things and comment them, and then we access the name using this Sujata display author name, which is a public function. So we'll see how it works. See, there is no error. So which means what we have done here is, in this we have assigned variable for public and private, then we have declared one more public function through which we call this private function and return the variable to the main program. So this is how you can access a private function which is declared inside a class. You cannot access a private function directly from the main program. You have to declare a public function, and from public function only you can access a private function, and then you can return that value to the main program.